Hey everybody, it's Jade on Piano, where we make music make sense. Today, we're talking about four tricks to make boring chords sound awesome. Stick around. Okay, so let's get right into this. We're talking about four tricks to make boring chords sound awesome. Why are we doing that? Because sometimes people just want simple ways to improve what they play. So I want to use a song in the key of C today. We know our notes in the key of C, most of us do, but let's go ahead with the scale. That's C major. And I'm going to take the song. Hold on, I got my notes over here. Okay, I want to take the song Set a Fire. Let me play it the normal way first. I'm going to try to play the melody. And then if you play it again. And then we start over. So basically it's 1 to 4. And then the first time you go to the 1 in first inversion, back to the 4. Second time, 1, 4, 6, 4. So, you know, pretty basic, pretty straightforward song. Pretty cool, nice melody, all those things. What are some things we can do to spice this up? Number one on my list, hold on, let me check. Yeah, okay, number one on my list, arpeggios. So let's look at that. Let me go lower. Hold on. Screen about to go out. Okay, so if we do that, but how about we mix it up even with those arpeggios? Chord. So I just put in arpeggios, you know, and that time I put only one. But you can mix where you put in an arpeggio, so it doesn't have to be the same way every time. You could make chord, then arpeggio, chord, arpeggio, or chord, arpeggio, arpeggio, arpeggio. Any order you want. You can mix and match that the whole time, making just the arpeggio. So how did I make the arpeggio? A lot of times, 1-5-1-2-3 is nice. So here's my one chord. 1-5-1-2-3 chord. Of this chord, this is a 1-5-1-2-3. What did I do for the minor one when I did that one? 1-5-1-2-3. Gave it a nice feel for that as well. So that's some arpeggios. The number two way, inversions. Now I was already doing some of this when I was playing the first time, but let's look at it this way. If you're a beginner, you may just be playing it in root. So that would be in root, but if I want to make this sound awesome, check this out. First of all, I started right here. Look at my right hand. I'm in a first inversion right now. I've got the melody on the top. I don't even have to change this. Now check that out. This is what I did originally. Now let me try something. That's still an F chord. See that? So let me do that again. So I use some arpeggios, I use some inversions. Real simple way to throw some inversions into the song. This is F major, and I didn't even have to change my right hand. I simply put the A in the bass for my left hand. That's all I did. Gave that a real nice feel there. Now, that is inversions. Number three, chord quality. Chord quality. So what am I saying about chord quality? Well, look at this here. Check this out. You see that? Now, if I wanted, that would be a better representation of changing chord quality. Let me try that again. Now, I prefer to change that chord quality in the middle instead of just straight like that. Let me see. Control. Oh. I want to go major here first. Hear how that pulls on that just a little bit more when I delayed it, because you're committed here. Oh, right chord. Right, so I changed the chord quality from major to minor. Real quick way right there. Now the last one could be progressions. Number four, progressions. And so I want to, and I'm tying progressions and reharm into the same area. So check this out. Okay, let's start here. So we're back. What did I do? I changed. So instead of going to the four is still present here in my right hand, but it's hidden inside this B flat major nine chord. Okay. See, it's hidden inside the chord, or B flat major seven. And then I went back to our A minor that we already had to reestablish it. Now here's that chord change we did just a moment ago, changing the chord quality, but now it's in a different inversion. So it feels, it's F minor, but it also kind of feels like it really is the A flat. It's just in first inversion though. So we used several for that. We used inversions, we changed the chord quality, and we included it in our progression. Okay, another way to change the progression. Now this looks like the same thing as before as far as the F minor, but if you look very closely, it's not just F minor, it's an F minor 6, or it's D minor 7 flat 5. See that? Also known as half diminished. So D minor 7 flat 5 or F minor 6. The other one was a straight F minor. So this one has a little bit more packed into it. You see that? So using, that's why I said reharm or chord progressions is the way that I'm looking at that fourth way. I'm my key for this is still focused on the key of C, but I was kind of approaching it from a melody perspective. Let me keep that melody. I was really supposed to go to a 4. Well, what else can use that? What else can use that? Maybe the G. So let me try that. Let me see. Gets me, I could use the G. It gets me kind of the same place as before. How about that first inversion? I could use that. What is just about a straight D minor? How do we feel about it? I'm just mixing elements that we already talked about. I just walk straight up scale with that. C chord, D minor chord, but here's my F hidden inside. First inversion, using an inversion. And then I used a chord quality change to get there. So I'm using all these elements. The song is really super simple, but we've played it about 5 or 6 different ways already. Let's try something else. Let's see. How about I go here? No, wrong chord, sorry. Let's try it again. See, this is me experimenting further. Those were the ones that were more obvious to me. That one's way too far out. I would need to set up first. So I used things that were more closely related. I don't want to take too long to bring this video forward to you guys, but take those options already. You just saw me use a couple more that would have to we would probably have to put 3 or 4 more chords in, which probably wouldn't be appropriate for that. But some beginning options here, moving into the more advanced as you begin to explore these ideas of adding those types of 4 things to your chords to make them awesome. You see, I took a simple song, 1-4-1-4, or 1-4-6-4, either way. And even the 1-4-6-4 is an upgrade of the 1-4-1-4, but that's essentially how it's playing out. So you guys take that, run with it, play with it, experiment with it, not just in the key of C, but in other keys. Take those 4 elements. Let me read the list so I don't say them out of the order. Arpeggios, inversions, changing the chord quality, and progressions. Take all of that, run with it, use it. You guys, let me know in the comments how you make your chords awesome. So take care, have a blessed week.